Well, hello there, and we are running the system without hardware acceleration, so therefore it's going to blow up in our face. Anyway, it's a virtual machine. Leap 15.4, I think it is, just came out, and I have itchy bitchy thing here. And I don't want to do a review of Leap. There's plenty of videos out there that do review, but I want to kind of make you understand what openSUSE Leap is a little bit better. So I just booted it up here. And I think the first thing is we can do here is we can go into the good old internet and we can open up Google. I've been running this since the release candidate came out. So I already customized it and set it up for my liking. So if you go into openSUSE here. So if you look at their website here, we have Tumbleweed, this little bit here. Get the newest Linux packages with our rolling, released, fast, integrated, stabilized, tested. Look at Tumbleweed as art with more testing. Leap, this little dude over here that just got released here, is get the most complete Linux distribution with openSUSE's latest regular release version. So think about Leap as following the static or jump release, where you change version numbers. You know, the repositories are being maintained for X amount of time, and then you have to jump repository, go from version 1 to version 2 to version 3 to version 4, and they freeze packages in the repositories, focusing more on stability and security, way more than Tumbleweed and most rolling releases. And if you go in here to more information, they actually talk a little bit more about it here, what it is. But and it's also following the SUSE's Enterprise Linux. I think that's what it's called. I can never remember. Yeah, SUSE Enterprise Linux. So what Leap is doing is that it's following the release schedule or it's basically an open source version of SUSE Enterprise Linux. So 15.4 is basically based on the same code base as SUSE Enterprise Linux 15.4. Look at it like this: when Red Hat had their CentOS version, you know, it was basically just Red Hat without the proprietary bit or marketing bits in it and some of the proprietary bits in it. That's basically what Leap is, if you want to think about it like that. It's SUSE Linux done by the community, or maintained by the community. So they're using the same code base, they are updating from the same repositories. If you install Leap, if you go in here right now and we look at the repositories, you can see here we're actually getting updates from SUSE Linux Enterprise 15 because they're kind of following along. And if you want to go from Leap to SUSE Enterprise Linux, you can do that in a GIF. You can just subscribe to SUSE Linux Enterprise and you're on that. You don't need to reinstall or anything like that. You basically just change repository over to the subscription repository. It's really, really easy with a command. I can't remember right now. But you basically pay for the support, and now you're running SUSE Linux Enterprise. It's that easy. That's the idea with it. It's to give people an option for SUSE Linux Enterprise that don't need the extended support, don't need the professional backend that SUSE is giving it, but just want the stability and the productivity and the security from SUSE Linux Enterprise. So therefore, that's what openSUSE Leap is. Another way that I like to think about openSUSE Leap, that because a lot of people are like, oh, it's outdated with the software and stuff like that. So if we go in here, we go into DistroWatch. The best way that I kind of can explain to you guys what openSUSE Leap is, also if you want to like understand the philosophy behind it, why they're freezing the packages a little bit outdated, and we're going, I think at last we'll talk about the kernel. Think about openSUSE Leap as Debian stable. They're kind of following the same philosophy. Stability, security, wireless. It comes first. That's it. Stability and security. Where Tumbleweed, Art, and other like that, they do think about security, they do think about stability, but their main focus is getting you the latest technologies all the time. Okay? So think about openSUSE Leap like Debian's testing. Oh, sorry, stable. But it's a little bit different than Debian stable, because I would guess, because openSUSE Leap, they kind of update a service pack once a year, so we're still on the 15 prans. But 15.4 gave us a newer kernel, you know, instead of the old kernel. So if you go in here, we do uname, you can see we on kernel 5.14. So it's not, when 15.0 came out, or 15.1, they froze the package repositories. they froze some packages. And then when they come a new service pack out, depending on what the needs are, they may update the desktop environments, they may update the kernel and stuff like that. Why I have Ubuntu up here is because I have noticed that it's kind of following a little bit with the, what Ubuntu is doing with the LTS release. So every 2 years, I was about to say four, every 2 years in general with Leap, you get an updated kernel, you get updated programs, you know, they unfreeze the software and they update the software to the latest LTS release or to the latest stable version of that those packages that are being that has been tested and validated as being the most secure and stable version of the desktop environments, the packages, and then they kind of freeze them a little bit for about 2 years again, and then they update the kernel again. It's not set in stone, but the last couple of years, if you look at the release from openSUSE here, and you see with Leap, when do they update the kernel? Every 2 years. When do the update, a lot of the report software in the repositories for 15 dot whatever it is, every 2 years, kind of like what Ubuntu LTS is doing. I would say Leap is like a mixture between Ubuntu LTS and Debian, because Leap sometimes have a little bit newer packages than Debian have. And every 2 years when a dot release comes out, or every 1 year, every 2 years when a dot release comes out, kind of once a year. So 15 released, openSUSE Leap 15 comes out, then a year or so later we got 15.1, and then a year or so later after that we get 15.2, and that's kind of when they also do a lot of refreshing in the repository, for the most part. And then they do 15.3, they kind of keep a lot of the same software from 15.4, and then when 15.4 15.2, and then when 15.4 come out, they kind of refresh the repositories a little bit again. Basically, a little bit what Ubuntu is doing, like every 2 years with the LTS release, you get upgraded software, you know, when you jump from 2104, and you're jumping to 2204, you get newer GNOME, newer KDE, and stuff like that. But they tend to be a little bit behind Ubuntu LTS in some aspects. So it's a, like I said, it's a little bit mixed between that. This is not set in stone. This is not totally how they've done it. It's just the last 5 or so years they've kind of done it. They kind of followed the package refreshes in the repositories, in the 15 series repositories, a little bit like they did with Ubuntu. Like every second year, you got a newer kernel and blah, blah. Sometimes that goes a year between you get new kernel. It's a little bit, you kind of have to follow along with it. To see what's when they're doing it. What Leap is meant for, it's meant for you out there that just want stability. You're not that fussed with the latest and greatest features. You only are caring about stability, security. That's the alpha omega. Basically, you want a system where you think about it this way is probably the best way of thinking about it. openSUSE Leap is for situation where you would have been using SUSE or Red Hat Enterprise Linux or Ubuntu LTS. Those are the cases you would be running Leap, or you would be running Debian Stable. That's the user group Leap is meant for. And you can run it at home, you can backport stuff in, there are community repositories to get a new kernel, and you would, you know, if you go on to SUSE software here, there are ways where you can get a new kernel on the Leap. You know, think about this section here as Ubuntu's PPAs. You can actually get a newer version of Cinnamon instead of the one that I'm running right here that I think is 4.6. You can actually, there's actually a community repository in here. So if you do Cinnamon Desktop and we go in here, this is the official release on the Tumbleweed 5.0. If you go here, you can see 15.4, you click community packets, we have 5.0 here, we click download, add repository manually, or we can click this link here, we can basically download this link and you can open it with the YAST software tool and it will add the repositories and all of those things. Anyway, I'm nerding out a little bit here. I think I may do a video about how to install this. openSUSE here is trying to cater to both. Basically, they are trying to cater to both audience within the Linux community. We have the adventurous, I need everything being shiny and new and all of that right now. You know, the arts people, the, you know, that fucking gets, oh my God, there's a new version out. I don't know if I need it. There's just a higher number than the one I had before. I just need it. Like, they don't care that the newer version number just mean that they, you know, they moved up this little icon up here a pixel to the left. They don't care. It's a higher version number than the one I have. That's all I care about, okay? That's what you have Tumbleweed and Arts and those kind of distributions for. And then there are people that are more focused on actually doing real work. You know, they want a system that don't break all the time. They want a system that, yeah, may be a little bit outdated, but they know it's stable. They know it works because they care about what is the uptime. How long can I keep this system running without it shitting its pants? Because I need to develop, I need to code, I need to research, I need to use it as a server and stuff like that. So this is kind of the two group of people that openSUSE is catering to with Tumbleweed and Leap. And it's really important that you understand what openSUSE Leap 15.4 really is and how it functions within the ecosystem of Linux and the ecosystem of openSUSE. And again, I mentioned that before. The kernel. I'm going to talk about the kernel a little bit here. Because people, they tend to get so bent out of shape that Ubuntu is running an older kernel, Leap is running an older kernel, Debian is running an older kernel. The kernel that openSUSE is running right here, and the kernel that you're getting from, you know, the 15.4 kernel that you get from Linus Torvalds, they are not the same kernel. They are using a lot of the same technologies, and look at it like this. This kernel here is based upon 15.14. Think about it a little bit as it's a fork, or it's a, like you have like EndeavorOS based on Arch. You have Manjaro based on Arch. You have Ubuntu based on Debian, you know, or a fork of Debian. So a kernel can more or less be based on, that's what you see here. This means that it's based or forked from or modified from 15.14. So that don't mean that, oh my God, I'm not getting any more hardware support and firmware support and stuff like that. And I can show you guys that really, really easy here. So if you go into the software management here. So if you just Google firmware, you can see this is from 2022. You have like Bluetooth, AMD GPU and stuff like that. So they are basically adding in support for newer hardware into the kernel. And this is why you can install an older kernel into a new system. A lot of people, they only care about this number here, 5.14. And then they go on to kernel.org and they read the support, hardware support and the features, and they're like, yep, that's just the same for all kernels then. No, a Ubuntu kernel is not the same as a vanilla kernel, and it's not the same as an openSUSE kernel. So 15.4 under openSUSE is not the same kernel or done in the same way as 15.4 under Ubuntu. A 15.4 kernel under openSUSE may have way more hardware support than even a 5.15 kernel have under Ubuntu because of the modularity that you can plug that into the Linux kernel. And a lot of people seem to be not understanding this, and it can look really crazy, you know, it can be confusing if you're not have researched this yourself. It is confusing, I will give you that. So I hope this helped you guys out. See you all later, and I think I'll go and try and see if we can install what happens if we install the Cinnamon desktop. So yeah, see you all later. Bye bye.